Write the face value and place value of two nines in the given number. This is the sum I have given in your previous homework. Okay, what is the question they are asking? Face value and place value of two nines. Okay, what is the place face value? As per the concept, the face value is the digit itself. So, face value of two nines in given number is 9. This is the answer for the first one. Next, place value of two nines. How do you write the place value? Few students commit mistake in that. That's why I am repeating it now. Okay. Now I give you a very easy method to write the place value. Okay. First, see the 9 where it is located in the given number. Now write the 9 as it is. 9. After 9, how many digits you have children? 2. So you have to add 2 to it. Okay. Next, see. Where is the 9 located? It is located here. After 9, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So add 5 zeros with this 9. That's easily the place value of 9. Don't follow everyone this method, children. Those who are struggling to write the answer only follow this method to find the place value. You have to write this step also along with this answer. I hope you understand this. Okay? Let us, once again, we are going to see about Indian system of numeration. Why we are going to see Indian system of numeration is, today we are going to see another system of numeration. So after seeing that system of numeration, you may have confused with both the system. So to avoid that confusion, we are come strong with this Indian system of numeration. That's why once again we are recalling this Indian system. Okay, do you remember, children, how many periods in Indian system of numeration?
Yes.
Ones, thousands, lakhs, crores. These are the 4 periods in Indian system of numeration. What are the place value comes under the period ones? Ones, tens, hundreds. Yes, very good. What are the place value comes under thousands? Yes, thousands, ten thousands. These are the place value comes under the period thousands. What are the place value comes under the period lakhs? Lakhs, 10 lakhs. What are the place value comes under crores? Crores, 10 crores. Now we are going to read the place value of Indian system at a stretch. Okay? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10 thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. Totally we have 9 place values, children. Once again we are going to say the place values. Okay? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10 thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. You have to remember all these 9 place values in the Indian system of numeration. Before that, in Indian system of numeration, you must know the how to use comma. We have already seen in the previous class. Now we are going to recall it. How do you use the comma, children? Starting from the right, the first comma is placed after the first digit. That is 1, 2, 3. Here we have the first comma. Then after every 2 digits, we have placed in the next commas. Why we place this comma? You have to call this as a period. This is a period of crores. And this is the period of lakhs. And this is the period of thousand. And this is the period of ones. In today's homework, you have the one question like this. Okay, in the question, what I am asking is, you have to write the number and you have to place the commas as per the Indian system of numeration. And then you have to write the what are the periods coming in the number. Okay. Now you say what are the periods coming in this number? Ones, thousands, lakhs, crores. Suppose in the homework question, if they given up to this, like this means you have only the 2 periods. So in the question you have to write only the 2 periods. That is ones, thousand. Suppose in your homework question, if you have the question up to the lakhs period only, lakhs period, lakhs place value means, in that question, how do you write? Ones, tens, lakhs. But also, for that sum also, you have to mention the period of lakhs. Do you understand, children, what I am saying? So, now we place the commas as per the Indian system of numeration. Now, I tell you here how to write the number name very easily by using the Indian system. Once the number is given to you, children, you first by using the pencil shortly write the place value of the given number. For wants, use the letter O. For tens, use the letter T. For hundreds, H. For thousand, use TH because you are having T for tens. So you are using TH for thousand. And for 10,000, T dot TH. And for lakhs, L. And for 10 lakhs, T dot L. For crores, C. And 10 crores, T dot C. We are clear, children. Now we are going to say the number name for this given number. Okay. You have to read this period of number as whole. Okay. You have to read this number as whole. 1, 3, that is 13. 2, 4, 24. 5, 3, 53. 0, 1, 2. So there is no place referral here. So you have to read as 12. Now we are going to say the number name. While you are saying the number name for this, you are saying choosing one period and you have to say the place value of the right hand side number. In 13, which is the right hand side number 3. What is the place value of 3? So crore. So you have to say the place value of crore only. That is 13 crore. Do you understand, children? In 24, that is the right hand side number 4. So you have to say the place value of 4 only. What is the place value of 4? Lakhs. So 24 lakhs. Here 53, on right hand side you have 3. What is the place value of 3? 1000. So you have to say the place value of 3 only, that is 1000. 53,000. Now we are going to say the number name for it. 13 crore, 24 lakhs, 53,000 and 12. Here you don't have 100 value. So you are using the conjunction and after the 1000. And 12. Once again we are going to say the name, children. 13 crores, 24 lakh, 53,000 and 12. I hope you understand, children. Thus today, children, we are going to see about international system of numeration. What is the main international system of numeration? Before seeing the system, how to use commas in international system of numeration? Let us see. Starting from the right, commas are placed after every third digit. Do you understand, children? Once again, I am going to read this definition. Starting from the right, commas are placed after every third digit. Do you understand? That is, every third digit you are going to place commas. Let us see this example. Starting from the right of the number. Starting from the right of the number, count 1, 2, 3. Here you have to place the first comma. That is every. Every means every three digit you have to put the comma. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Before you don't have any number, so you have to stop the comma up to this. Similarly, second one. Starting from the right hand side. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Before you have only one number, so you are stopping the comma up to this. I hope you all understand, children. In Indian system of numeration, starting from the right, after the first three digit, we are placing the first comma. And the next, every two digit, you are placing the commas in Indian system of numeration. But in international system of numeration, for every three digit, you are using the commas. I hope you are very clear in use of commas in international system of numeration. Next, children, we are going to see about what are the periods in international system of numeration. In Indian system also, we have periods. Similarly, in international system also, you have periods. What are the periods in international system? You have three periods. One is ones, next thousands and millions. These are the three periods in international system of numeration. Okay. And what are the place value comes under the period ones? As in the Indian system, the place value ones, tens, hundreds. These three place values comes under the period ones. Do you understand, children? And then what are the place value comes under thousand? Is 1000, 10,000, 100,000. This is the new term you are going to see here. You are seeing here 100,000. 1000, 10,000, 100,000. These are the three place value comes under the period 1000. And next period is million. What are the place value comes under the million? Is millions, 10 millions, 100 millions. Do you understand, children? What are the place value? Millions. How do you pronounce it? Millions, 10 millions, 100 millions. Now we are going to read all these place values now. Ones, tens. 100, 1000, 10,000. Up to this, you have the same place value in Indian system also. Okay. Up to this, you have the same place value in Indian system. That is 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000, 10,000. After the 10,000, you have what the place value in Indian system? Yes, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. Instead of lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores, here you have 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million. Do you understand, children? Here also you have 3 place values. In Indian system also you have 9 place values. In international system also you have the 9 place value. Once again you are going to read this. Okay, read along with me, children. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, 100,000s, millions, 10 millions, 100 millions. Are you clear, children? Now, children, you are seeing place value chart for international system of numeration. From this place value chart, you can easily understand what are the periods in international system and what are the place values comes under the each period and how can you read the number by using international system. Okay, see the chart, children. What are the periods in international system? It have only 3 periods. They are ones, thousands, millions. Okay, under ones, how many place values are there? Ones, tens, hundreds, as in the Indian system. And under the thousands, you have thousands, 10,000s. Up to 10,000s, you have the same place value as in the Indian system. Instead of, after the 10,000, in Indian system, you have lakh. Instead of lakh, here you are having 100,000. These 3 place value comes under the period of thousands. Similarly, after the 10 lakh, crore and 10 crores, you have the place value in the Indian system. Instead of the place values, here we are having millions, 10 millions, 100 millions under the period of millions. It's clear, children. Next, we are going to read these numbers by using international system. Before you read the number, you have to place the comma by using international system. By international system, how we are placing comma? Starting from the right. Every time I am saying use of comma, I am saying starting from the right only. Why? Because if you start from the left hand side, you may it should be wrong. You have to start from the right only. Starting from the right, after every 3 digit, we have to place the comma. Then 1, 2, 3. After that, we are placing 1 comma. Similarly, 1, 2, 3. After that, we are placing 1 comma. 1, 2, 3. After that, we are placing 1 comma. Similarly, 1, 2, 3. You are placing 1 comma. 1, 2, 3. After these 3 digits, we are placing the next comma. Before that, we have only 2 digits. So, we are starting up to this. Before this comma, you have only 1 digit. So, you are starting up to this. Similarly, see this number. In this number, you have only 9 digits, children. So, first you are only 1, 2, 3. You are placing first comma. 1, 2, 3. You are placing the next comma. 1, 2, 3. Before that, you don't have any number. So, you have to stop up to this. Do you understand how to place commas by using international system? Next, we are going to place these digits in the corresponding places to them. Okay? See the first one. It is a 6-digit number. First, you are going to write the 2 in its place. 2 is present in 1's place. So, you have to write the 2 in 1's place. Next, 1 is present in 10's place. Thus, you are writing 1 in 10's place. Similarly, 4 is present in 100's place. That's why you are writing 4 in 100's place. Similarly, what is the next number? 6. 6 is present in which place? 1000's place. Thus, you are writing 6 in 1000's place. Like that, 8 in 10,000's place. Right? Like 2 in 100,000's place. Okay, so we understand how we are writing the number in their corresponding places. See, children, you have to read that period of number as a whole. Okay? In this number, there are only 2 periods. In your homework, today you have one sum like this. In that sum, what they are asking is, you have to place the commas between the numbers as per the system. As per the system is, Indian system is, you have to place the commas by using the Indian system. That is, first 3 digit and the next 2 digit. As per the international system means every 3 digit. Okay, you have to place the comma after every 3 digit, and you have to name, you have to write the names of the periods which in the which comes under that number. Like see this example 286412. It's a 6 digit number. In this number, it's covered only the 2 periods only. What are the 2 periods? 1 and 1000. See children, there is no number in the period of millions. So if the sum is like this, that is 6 digit number means you have to place the comma like this. After placing the comma, you have to write the periods equal to 1000 only. No need to write the million. It's clear children. Similarly, see this sum. We have placed the digits in their corresponding places. But it is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 digit number. We have one more digit. So you are placing the 6 in millions place. Now children, how do you write the periods for this number? See children, 9, 7, 5 is comes under the period of 1s. So you are writing the 1s period. 1, 4, 3, it comes under the period of 1000. So you are writing the 1000s period. But 6, among these 3 place values, only one number is entered. Though one number is entered, you have to write the name of the periods. What is the name of the periods? Millions. So, what are the periods covered by this number? Is 1000 millions. Do you understand children? What are the periods covered by this number? 1000. 1000. That's all. What are the periods covered by this number? 1000 millions. Even a single number entered in this period, you have to write the name of the period. Similarly, how many periods this number cover? 1000 million. Similarly, this one also. Do you understand children? How you are going to place the commas? How you are going to write the name of the periods? Next children, we are going to read this number by using international system. You can easily read this number by using Indian system. Now we are going to read this number by using international system. Listen carefully children. As I said before, you have to read the period of number as 4. This is one period of number, 286. So you have to read this number as 4. 286. While you are saying 286 in international system, you no need to use the conjunction and for the period of millions, thousands. You have to use the conjunction and in both Indian system and international system in the period of once only. Do you understand what I am saying children? You have to use the conjunction and in once period only. See children, in once period you are having 412. You have to read it as 412, 975, 728, 146. But if you are reading this number, 200 and more, don't read like this, 286, 143, 564, 837. Similarly, you have to read 592. Do you understand children? You have to read this number as 4 and you don't use the conjunction and in the period of millions, thousands, you have to use the conjunction and in ones place, ones period in both Indian system as well as the international system. Now we are going to read this number by international system. As in the Indian system, you have to say the last number, that is right hand side number of the in the period, its place value. See children, 286412. 2 is present in 100,000 days and 8 is present in 10,000 days, 6 is present in 1,000 days. This is the one period of number. So you have to say the place value of 6 only. So you have to read it as 286,4412. It is very easy one. See the next one. How do you read this? This is the one period. In this period you have only one number. Its place value is million. So you have to read it as 6 million. In this period you have 3 numbers. You have to read it as 4. 143. What is the place value of 3? Thousands. So 143,975. Do you understand that? Once again we are going to say the name. 6 million. 6,143,975. Do you understand, children? Next, we are going to read this number. Okay, this is one period of number. Here we know the period number. So this is 31. You have to read this number as 31. This is the million period. Okay, you have to read this million of number as your whole. So you read this number as whole. 31. What is the base value of 1 million? So 31 million. You have to read this number as whole. 564. What is the base value of 4? Thousands. 564,728. Okay, it's clear, children. Next, you can read this number. This is one period of number. How do you read this? 592,837,146. It's clear, children. In this way only you have to read this number by using international system of numeration. It's clear, children. Thus, children, now we are writing the number names, okay, by using international system. See this example, children. We have already seen this example in the place value chart of international system, okay. Read this number. How do you read this number, children? 6 million. This is one period of number. This is one period of number. 143,975. See, children, while writing the number name, you have to use the conjunction and here only, not here. 100 and, you don't write here and. You have to write it as 143,000. 6 million. 143,975. It's clear, children. See the next one. I have written the place value here for 1000 and million only. Okay. This is place value of ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, 10,000, 100,000, million. Similarly, ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million. But we are writing the place value of this number only. Place value of this one, this number only. That is in the period, the last number. You are writing the place value of that last number. That is right and same number only. That's why I am writing the place value of 1000 and million only. Okay. How do you write the name for this number? Okay. 31 million. That is 31 million. And then you have to read this number as whole. 500. Don't use and. 564,000. And the next 728. Thus you are writing 728. You have to use the conjunction and in the period of ones, in the period of ones, in the period of ones, not in other periods. That is thousands period, millions period. In both Indian system also. Okay. Your next one is the number. This number contains 9 digit, children. First you are writing 592. I have written these 3 values as well. Okay. You can easily understand. 592 million. What is the base value of 2? Million. That's why you are writing million. 592 million. Next, 837,000. Next, 146. Similarly, these problems, similar to this problem, you have the homework sum. Okay, so observe this number name carefully, children. Do you understand, children? Next, children, you are having one comparison between Indian system and the international system. In your book, the international system of place value chart, they also given the comparison of Indian system and international system in the bottom of the place value chart of international system. Okay, in your classwork I have given that. Okay, but while I am teaching, I draw only the international system of place value chart only. Okay, now see, children, this is a simple understanding which make you Indian system and international system very easy, children. What are the place values of Indian system? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. These are the 9 place values in Indian system of numeration. What are the place values in international system of numeration? ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 billion. These are the place values in international system. Now we are comparing these place values. Okay. Up to this children, see these yellow color place values. These are same in both system, Indian system and international system. These five places are same only. After that, instead of lakh, we are having here 100,000. Instead of 10 lakhs, we are having here million. For crore, we are having 10 million. For 10 crores, you are having 100 millions. That's why in short, in your book, they give an assigned note. What is the note is? What is 100,000 is equal to? What is 100,000 equal to? See this one. 100,000, where is 100,000 here? 100,000 is equal to 1 lakh. So that is 100,000 equal to 1 lakh. Do you understand, children? What is 1 million equal to? See this number, children. 1 million is equal to, that's very good, 10 lakhs. What is 10 million is equal to? 10 million is equal to 1 crore. Similarly, 100 million is equal to 10 crores. Do you understand, children? 100,000 equal to 1 lakh, 1 million equal to 10 lakh, 10 million equal to 1 crore, 100 million equal to 10 crores. Do you understand, children? Do you have a clear idea about this international system, children? Next, children, we are going to see example 3. What is example 3 is, write the numerals for the following number names. Write the numerals. What is the numerals means? You have to write the number for the given number names. In this example, you have A, B, C, D, E, 5 sums. Among the 5 sums, I am doing here only 2 sums, children. What is the first one is 4,378,921. In which system they are using write the number name? Yes, they are using international system. They are using international system by writing this number name. Okay, now we are going to write the number for this number name. Okay, before that you have to draw the place value box like this. Okay, that is you have to write in this box, you have to write the place value of international system. What are the place values? Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million. After that, now we are going to write the numbers in their places. Okay, read the question once again. 4 million. So, 4 is in the place of million. So, instead to the million, we have to write 4 here. That's 4 million. And the next, 378,000. That is 18,000 space. So you have to write 18,000 place. That is 378. So you are writing 378,000. It's clear, children. Next, it is very easy. 921. Thus, you can easily write 921. Next, we are going to write this number here. Okay, this is the required number. Required number equal to write this number 4,378,921. Write this. After that, we are using the international system. So, you have to place the comma every 3 digit. 1, 2, 3, comma. Okay, it's clear, children. Next, you see this last example. The question is very simple, but the answer is little tough. Okay, what is the question? 2 crore, 3 lakh, and 7. 2 crore, 3 lakh and 7. This is using Indian system. Okay. What are the place value of Indian system? Similar to that, we also draw the box like this. What are the place value? Ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. Okay, children. These are the place values. Now we are going to write the numbers here. Okay, what is first here? 2 crore. So in the place value of crore, you have to write the number 2. That's why we are writing 2 here in the place of crore. 2. Then 3 lakhs. In the place value of lakhs, we have 3. So we are writing in the place value of lakh, we are writing 3. And 7. 7, it is a single digit number. So it is in the 1 space. So we are writing 7 here. What are the remaining places? Remaining places are empty. So we have to put the 0 here. Don't put 0 in front of the number, children. You have to, in between the number only, you have to add zeros. Don't write 0 here or there places, okay? You have to add 0 in these places. Next, we are going to write this number here. 2, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 0, 7. This, they are using Indian system of numeration. So, you have to place the comma. Starting from the right, first 3 digit. Next, you have 2 digit. We are placing the commas. Now, we write this number 2 crore, 3 lakhs and 7. That's such a thing. I hope you understand every concept we have discussed today. Thank you.
My dear children, in today's activity, you are going to learn a technique how to memorize the multiplication tables. Okay. Here we have taken 6th table. So first you have to write the table and memorize that. After that, you have to try to write the table in backward wise. Suppose if you are not able to write the table in backward wise, means once again read the table and then try to write the table in backward wise. So while you are memorizing the table in forward ways and backward ways, in both method means you can easily memorize the table and it should not, you should not forget them also. Okay, so this is a powerful method to memorize the table. Okay, similarly see here. Here we have written the tables in two parts. See here, these are the odd multiples of 6 and these are the even multiples of 6. See here, 1 6 is 6. 3 6 are 18, 5 6 are 30, 7 6 are 42, 9 6 are 54. See here, 2 6 are 12, 4 6 are 24, 6 6 are 36, 8 6 are 48, 10 6 are 60. So you have to read the table and memorize it like this. And then you have to try to reproduce the multiples of 6 like this in order. Odd multiples of 6 and even multiples of 6. Then you can easily bycut this 6th table. So this is also one of the method to memorize the 6th table. See here. Here instead of writing the table, here we have written only the multiples of 6. See here, 1 6 is 6, 2 6 are 12, 3 6 are 18, 4 6 are 24, 5 6 are 30, 6 6 are 36, 7 6 are 42, 8 6 are 48, 9 6 are 54, 10 6 are 60. So whenever you find very less time, you can also write only the answers only also. So we can easily recall the 6th table without writing the table by writing only the answers. So similarly, you can also at your home try some other tables like 7, 8 up to 16th table. You must memorize the tables. Okay. Try this method at your home, children, and memorize all the tables. Okay. Thank you.